Tell you what, is it only rock and roll or is it big business? It is super entertainment, right? An elitist cliche or rich white boys who won't let anyone else in, just like blacks who control rhythm and blues. Are we segregating our music too? I know it's only rock and roll, gang, but it is dividing our culture in some ways. Or is it too late to unite? I don't think so. I say, let the music give the answer. Come on. Scotty, how come my buddy Sam Kinison isn't here with you tonight? Huh? Let me introduce. Ah, zip it! Let me introduce home base up here for you. We have Stuart Goldman, who is a rock critic. Right? We got Joey Ramone. Joey Ramone from the Ramones, all right? And we've got buddy of mine. We got Ace Frehley, one of the founders of KISS, all right? Let me start with you, Stuart. Then, home base, of course. Home base, we got at, I should say at loudmouth number one, we've got Steve Whitaker, and at my buddy, Alex Mitchell, all right? Shakers of Power. Stewie, baby. Yes. Rock and roll has always been called the devil's music. You remember that from when you were a kid, yes. Right? When Elvis appeared on the Ed Sullivan Show, they didn't show him down below the waist, all right? Told not to shoot him down there. Is what we're seeing and hearing today any worse than the 1956 gyration?
Yeah, I'll tell you why. Because when Elvis came on, he was original. He started something. You mentioned Bob Dylan before.
Elvis,
Bob Dylan was original. Shut up. This guy, I've seen this guy 8 million times. This guy's going to have a day job in 5 years from now. We're never going to remember
him.
This is not original. This is just some gimp that looks like he crawled out of a garbage can.
Why? What does he look like? He doesn't look like a garbage can.
Play.
He's a friend of mine, pal.
There's 8 million bands in garages that play just like that.
How much do you know? All right, now you just made the move on him. How much do you know about his music?
I heard it. I've three chords.
How come you told our guitar player backstage that we sounded good?
Good guitar player.
Just do me one favor and tell the truth.
What was his last album?
Okay?
You remember his last album?
I never heard of this guy
before.
What is
his present
album? You probably even know one title of one of the songs.
I never heard of him.
That's because you don't know. Then how come?
How come you can nail him?
What are you doing here?
How come you can nail him? You're nailing him like so many other critics, baby. Like so many other critics without knowing what the hell is behind you.
I just heard him.
You're nailing him. Why don't you go marry Tipper Gore?
Sorry, you.
Why don't you marry someone like Tipper Gore?
Why don't you marry G. Gordon Liddy, pal? You want to make me into a bad guy.
I don't want to make you into a bad guy. You make yourself into a bad guy.
No.
You're attacking something you don't even know about.
No.
You've never heard their music.
I just heard it.
All right. Okay. Now, you've been around rock and roll since you were a kid.
Love it.
This is a guy who's been around rock and roll since he was a kid.
I think
he used to sing with the Replacements for the Kingston Trio. That's like, that's like re-singing for a replacement of a urinal, man, you know. Now, he's knocked you because you got a few whatever the hellish stuff.
Well, don't
is, you
think more that the skin prejudice is the worst prejudice in the world?
Skin prejudice?
Yeah. Skin prejudice.
That's like if you're putting down a black man or putting down the guy with tattoos because of the way his skin looks.
No,
you're a pretty weird character.
I don't care if you have tattoos.
Like
it's just that.
Wait a second.
So does
the last show you
people.
Were putting us down for our look. Now, no. I don't dress like I'm out of a Sears catalog or whatever.
When's the last time you washed your hair, pal?
You got them on.
When was the last time you washed your mouth?
Hey, Ace. Hey, look. Let me get to Ace. Wait a second. We're not getting anywhere here.
Didn't we hear this stuff in the 60s?
Anybody,
didn't I hear it 20 years ago, 30
you know
years
what,
ago?
Man?
Go get a haircut. Go wash your hair. Bathe every day.
In L.A.? No, no. But that's what you want to make me. But what I'm saying is...
Don't take cheap shots at me. We're talking about
music. This is Kmart. This is Kmart. You're a dime a dozen, man. I've seen guys like you walking down the street. There's nothing unusual about you. I don't care if you have tattoos or don't. If you want to have that for the rest of your life, good for you.
Ace,
I used to have stupid
Ace,
hair, too.
Let me come to you. God, we're getting nowhere with this. This guy should have been a dermatologist, not a critic, right? Let me get to Ace. Ace, let me ask you about it. You started a group called Kiss that created a whole new look for rock and roll. All right, okay. Now, what were you trying to do? What were you trying to do? Were you trying to convert rock and roll fans, or were you trying to create them into satanic cults?
Satanic cults and all that had nothing to do with it. We wanted to put on a rock and roll show, not only great music, but we wanted to put out a visual show that was just as good as the music.
All brought about not necessarily by a new generation of music, by a new generation of electronics, of lighting,
exactly,
and everything else. You tied it all in, made it a total entertainment package.
I mean, a lot of people think, you know, Kiss are multi-millionaires. For the first 5 or 6 years of touring, we broke even on the tours because we spent the amount of money that we made on tickets, we put right back into the show to make the greatest show in rock and roll.
Joey, the Ramones... The Ramones are the fathers of punk. What is the credo behind punk rock?
Well, love.
My daughter came home from dances, right? She came home with a bloody lip when she was 13.
You know what it is?
With scratches.
It's an attitude.
She did slam dancing.
You know what it is? It's an attitude. It's an attitude, whether it be... Ramones or Elvis Presley or Jim Morrison or you know what I mean?
Look,
the guy can't even articulate. He can't even talk.
My daughter came home, all right? Little Kelly came home when she was a kid, 13 years old. She's 22 now. She'd come home with bloody lips and noses, and she had her hair done in checkerboard squares, blue and yellow hair. It was really neat, man. I really dug it. I dug it so much I shaved her bald. She wanted to lead her class, so she let it fall.
Very conceptual, yeah.
Was that what that was? Conceptual? Let's talk about politics, all right? Before I do that, I want to go Steve. Steve, where's Steve? Okay, there you are, babe.
Hey.
You guys are the Mr. Cleans of hard rock.
Yes.
Would you like to hassle any of our other guests because of what they do in hard rock?
No, not at all. I think the problem is that... A lot of the bands, and these guys already early in an earlier show, accept the fact that we're accountable for what we do as bands, and we put out mass music and media and everything else, and there has to be an accountability for what's going on. And we've seen, we had our first American tour last year. We'd like to give you a t-shirt, Mort, if you'll accept this.
All right, nice.
And we saw...
That's a large... Where do you sell those in Japan?
T-shirt companies know what they're doing.
We saw too many thousands of people
this
who
does not,
get
I
influenced.
Hope, does not, I hope, have Jimmy Baker and Tammy on the back.
How many inches of record contract do you want to offer me?
Just wait till they get the right thing together.
Exactly, and that's what happened. All right, but seriously, let me ask you a question. Have you been put upon by anyone who says,
take it off, boy.
Do it. Sure, baby. You look like you can sing to me. Would you like to make a record? I'd just like to try for an average try. I mean, not necessarily a record, but... Safest sex I know, pal, is fully dressed. Steve, where's Steve? Okay, there you are, babe. You guys are the Mr. Cleans of hard rock.
Yes.
Would you like to hassle any of our other guests because of what they do in hard rock?
No, not at all. I think the problem is that a lot of the bands, and these guys already early in an earlier show, accept the fact that we're accountable for what we do as bands, and we put out mass music and media and everything else, and there has to be an accountability for what's going on. And we've seen, we had our first American tour last year. We'd like to give you a t-shirt, Mort, if you'll accept this.
All right, nice. And,
We saw...
That's a large?
That's a lot, yeah.
Where you sell those, in Japan?
Huh? T-shirt companies know what they're doing.
We saw too many thousands of people
this
who
does not,
get
I hope, this does not, I hope, have Jimmy Baker and Tammy on the back.
Okay,
that's nice. Yeah, I'll wear that. I'll wear that out to California. And I'll bring one up. You got an extra one?
Yes,
I'll bring it home to my girlfriend, all right?
Okay.
Lori will get one. Now, okay, you guys like to stay clean. So that means you don't get involved in problems with sex and drugs.
No, we're trying to make a difference. Exactly.
Are you making a difference in the statement of your music or in the statement of the way you maintain your own lives?
Both go hand in hand. Both go hand in hand. You can't live a life on stage and live a normal life differently.
Okay. You're right. So you, in other words, do not use drugs yourself.
Yeah.
Do not do music that professes the use of drugs as a great way of life.
Contrary to that.
The opposite.
Contrary.
Of that,
Do you guys sell big?
No, not yet. Not yet.
You think good will ever sell? And I don't mean good in a sense of culturally good, artistically good. I mean good in Mr. Goody Two Shoes.
Well, we're trying to make a living like Ace and everybody else, but it doesn't matter for us. We're just trying to make a difference. And whether we go, you know, multi-platinum, this Kiss did starting out, that's not really what our whole purpose is.
Who do people have to go to bed with to get records? I'd like to know who Ace went to bed with, or who went to bed with Ace to give him a record, all right? We're going to find out. Let's go. Ask about politics, all right? Honey, and honey, I love you, and you're looking good. Honey, did you have to go to bed with anyone to get a record contract?
If I had to go to bed with anyone to get where I am now,
no,
I'd
be get a record contract.
Toilets.
Get a
I
record
don't have
contract?
A record contract yet.
You don't have a record contract?
No.
Would you like one?
Are you making an offer, Mark? How many inches of record contract do you want to offer me?
Just wait till they get the right thing together.
Exactly, and that's what that means. All right, but seriously, let me ask you a question. Have you been put upon by anyone who says,
take it off, boy.
Chill out, baby. You look like you can sing to me. Would you like to make a record? I'd just like to try for an average try. I mean, not necessarily a record, but... Safest sex I know, pal, is fully dressed.
You know, the people who make those offers in the business are usually the ones that have no clout whatsoever.
Usually people who can't get you any place.
Well, people can get you places, but on an integrity level, I mean, I don't think we have to resort to such tactics. We're not into...
Does it go on, honey?
It probably does, but not in the circle that we know. We, you know, we like want to put the knee pads away for women in this industry. Yeah.
Where's Jesse? I want to talk to Jesse Nash. Is Jesse around here anyplace? Jesse, stick with us. Jesse, come here, second
mouth,
day. Come here, Mal.
Yeah.
Come here, music, Mal. Is the business of rock and roll still a dirty business in the sense of these guys trying to get themselves a record deal or get something going for themselves?
Let's put it this way. I think that anybody who's in this industry has got to draw their line of morals. And when I say that, means you have to stick to what you believe in. Nobody's ever going to get any further by going to bed with somebody. If anything, the mystery is gone. Especially when it comes to, from a woman's point of view. The point is you got to stick to what you believe.
Is it a dirty business?
It is a dirty business.
Is it dirtier than it ever was?
It's no dirtier than any other business. It's a corporation. And
all right, then let me go to Ace. Did you have to make any compromises to get you ahead? Or who did you have to kiss, huh, Ace?
What, are you serious?
Ace, baby. I mean, let's face it, all right?
Hey, I'm not homosexual, and the most...
I didn't say homosexual. Aren't there some women who run record companies?
Yes!
Huh? No. Megaforce Records run by a woman.
There's some women who run record companies,
not the people that I dealt with when it came to me.
You didn't have to do anything wrong, huh?
My last contract I signed with Johnny Z from Megaforce Records, and, you know...
Johnny Z is looked upon as one of the clean guys. You must have run into some dirty ones
before.
All
I had to do was have a tuna fish sandwich with him. That was the bottom line. No, seriously.
Johnny Z, you get big bonuses, huh?
I don't even pay royalties.
Well, that's no different than most record companies.
The way it is.
Nothing different about that.
No, but I would assume that if a female might have to do that.
I would have to go to bed?
I was never approached by that. You know.
Listen, there's the art of temptation.
Why is this guy even talking? He knows nothing about the business. I watched the other show.
He's a waste, man. He's a nobody.
Well, are we gonna reduce?
We got this bum out.
This is a circus, Maximus.
He's a nobody.
That's amazing. I haven't said anything yet, and they're all
coming.
Wait, people are busting their buns to make it. We got nobodies on his show. These are people giving their life to the business.
Sir, I gather
please
you don't...
Don't call me sir, man. Well, I don't know even what you are.
Evidently...
Don't address me.
Talk to each other. Go on down and talk to each other.
Fine.
Evidently, if I'm a nobody, then you're a nobody because you're putting me on the same level
please,
as you do.
Please.
Listen, we're adults here. We're adults here. Why don't we sit there and talk like adults? What's the matter? You intimidated? Talk to me like a
man. I'm here.
Words have made you? You lost your tongue? You had a big mouth to me out in the hall there. You're afraid to speak when your time is, you've got it in your corner.
All right.
You mind if I belt
him? Let him talk.
Yeah, yeah.
Let him talk.
Go ahead, Z. I'm not going to have a shouting match with you.
I'm not having a shouting match. I'm talking to you, baby.
The thing is this, I don't even know how you got on the show.
I'll be honest. You know something? I write.
Ace, come here.
I write.
You've done more interviews than anybody in the world, including God, okay?
Yeah.
Did you ever hear of this bum?
Yeah. Brains.
The bum.
Real literate,
Scott! Real literate man here.
You know this guy?
Who is he representing? The bottom line is, I've read about acts that are happening right now.
For who? The Woman's Wear Journal?
Sit down with me, Jess.
Tell you what,
we're going to find out if rock and roll has become even more racist. I want to hear from you. Mr. Z, I want to hear from you, baby, all right?
Yeah.
Stay with us. Incidentally, the hottest heavy metal record company in the United States is run by a woman, isn't it?
What company is that?
You don't know? There's
Megaforce Records.
Let me go, if you will, to you, Johnny Z.
Uh-oh.
All right. For years, MTV wouldn't play metal, punk, or black music. Now they play metal and punk, but very little black. Why?
I think
they don't photograph as well.
That was a joke.
And then this, let me hear you, Johnny Z.
Everything is basically dictated by cash registers. I remember in 1983 trying to get a heavy metal band signed to the record company, and I used to see A&R guys standing like this. They couldn't even take the records off that I was putting on. The only thing a record company hears is the jingle jangle of the machine. And whatever's hot, whatever the cash dictates, that's what they're involved with. To answer your question exactly.
Scotty, you got to come in here with me, babe.
Payola.
Let me introduce Scotty in, all right? Scott, of course, was with Anthrax.
Yeah.
Scotty. Why, babe? Why is heavy metal all white?
It's hard to say, you know.
Same reason, maybe that art, rhythm, and blues is almost all black.
It's a lot has to do with peer pressure. You know, growing up when you're a teenager, when you start listening to music, and You know, you're 12, 13 years old, and you just get in with the crowd. And generally, I guess white kids have always listened to rock and roll and heavy metal. And it's the same with rap music, I think. You know, black teenagers are growing up with kids who are also listening to rap music.
At least you're getting white kids doing rap music. You're not getting black kids doing heavy metal.
You know, you don't dance to heavy metal.
Living color.
You're going on tour. Anthrax going on tour pretty soon. They're going to do a pretty interesting experiment. There, your opening act is Colors, isn't it, over there?
Living Color, yeah.
Which is a black group. Stuart, where's Stuart? Stuart, you're out there. I want to ask you, as a rock critic, why is the music so divided along racial lines? Has it been this way historically?
First of all, the idea that blacks are segregated against is absurd. In one sense, the real black guys, like Sonny Boy Williamson and Furry Lewis, and the guys who
started... The guys who started...
I mean, rock and rollers are always falling all over themselves paying homage to blacks, but the fact is that all the blues players in Louisiana that started this stuff are still broke and still living in little shacks. And so the whole idea that... that now blacks are equal is garbage.
Well, wait a minute, whose fault is that? Is it our fault that they're living in shacks?
Well, maybe it is, considering you ripped off their four chords. Maybe you should give them a little of it. Tell me you can play as good as and then we'll talk about it, right? And what about one of the biggest selling groups in America is Public Enemy. Do you see
he says, put on an Anthrax record and listen to a Sonny Boy Williams influence.
Is it that?
Where?
Where's his royalties, man?
Huh?
Where's his royalties?
I'm saying you won't hear it. I'm saying I defy you to hear it.
Almost every riff they ever played off you those guys, people. They didn't get. Did they give him a cent?
We're not
no.
talking about Led Zeppelin.
We're not talking
about
them.
Led Zeppelin. You're talking about apples
and oranges.
Well,
you ripped off Led Zeppelin, man.
Did we?
No, not you. Ace.
Oh, okay.
I was a member of the Kiss Army when I was 12,
you
man. I know what it's
Kiss
about.
Army. Why were you a member of the Kiss Army?
Because I was 12 years old. It's 14 years later.
You didn't know any better.
That's right. But now I do.
Where's Queen Vixen? Where's Queen Vixen? Queen Vixen, come on up here a second, will you please? I want to see the Queen a second. Take this, you nice lady, and let me ask you a question. Not only are blacks excluded, I think there are only about three white groups in heavy metal who are women, aren't there?
Yeah.
And you're one of them.
Well, we're one of them. We're not signed, though. There's Vixen, there's Femme Fatale.
Girl School
is a good female heavy metal band.
And none of them can play.
How come?
Just like
How
you.
Come? Because, I mean, what the hell's going on?
What?
None of them can
play. No female can play an instrument.
Go back.
Just like
none
you.
Of
go
them can play.
Go back to Boys Town.
You guys need to go
man?
Back and learn how
like
to play guitar.
Here,
you can't even
right?
play.
It's like the Nerd Squad.
These are Queen. Queen, these are critics. These are the
critics?
People. These are the
right.
people who
They're
decide
tools.
What is good music. They decide what's good.
You guys are too old,
That's
man.
That's why
you're
we have a job
old.
And you're
no
not signed.
No idea what's going on. No idea. You're
you
way
think,
too old.
You think maybe they're still in the Herman's Hermit generation?
Yeah, what is this? Kingston Trio, right? When was the last time anybody here put on
what's
a Kingston
gone?
Trio album, right? Okay. Give me Circus of Power.
Wrong,
and
I was. That's okay.
Any day.
Look.
All right. I'll tell you what. I still want to find out exactly what goes on behind the producers' doors. Who's laying down on the job? Let's do that next. Let's see for just a second if I can get inside Ace's head. Ace, you're on the road, all right? Rock and roll stars are accused of trashing hotels, nightclubs, everything else, all right?
Yeah.
Give me your best on the road story.
Well, you know, there's probably
no, give it to me, don't I? Don't know, man.
There's a dozen good ones. You know, a lot of rock stars get bad raps. You know, you're on the road 3, 4, 5 weeks at one point in time. And you don't have a chance to see your family, see your friends, you know, and you get frustrated, you know. The night before, I was supposed to do a big concert in Chicago. My favorite guitarist, my guitar already dropped, the neck cracked in half. You know, I was... Aww! Come on.
Well, let me hear his story, man. Let me hear his story. What'd you do? What'd you do? Drop your pencil and break your lead, baby?
Hey, hey.
Let me hear his story.
So what did I do? You know, I got back to the hotel room, you know. I had a couple of beers. Next thing I know, a TV was flying out the window.
What's those things, Adam? I mean, you know, I got to tell you, here's other things.
Before I threw the TV, I made sure nobody was down there.
All right, I worked for a joint. Years ago when I was on the road, I worked for a joint that gave me a $4,000 bum check.
Yeah.
All right? You get back, you need that money to get to the next spot, sure, to pay your band. You don't have any money. I got back to the room. So I threw the television set through the wall. I trashed the bed. I did some things to the, you know, I did about $15,000 worth of damage. So when you hear the stories about how rock and roll stars are dumping stuff out the window of the Plaza Hotel, you got to know some of the stories that went on before where they got treated like maybe dirt when they walked through the lobby.
Something like that unprovoked. Morton,
how about?
That's the thing, though. I mean, they, you know, rock stars thrive on this bad. I'll talk to you after the show in the parking lot. Okay. These rock stars.
So let's hear from the Dave Clark Five.
All in one. These rock stars thrive on the bad boy image. This wonderful lady here, bad girl image.
Lady here. Right away, you had to touch your bare arm, right?
Circus. Did I?
With your scabby hand.
Tell them more.
Circus of Power. I mean, they're hot. They're good. I like them. They got great ink too. I dig your ink. But you thrive on this bad boy image, and you guys are signed to RCA. You know, you were with major labels for years.
Man, we are what we are.
But you're being sucked up by corporate America. So what do you stand for?
What's wrong with corporate America? What is wrong with corporate America?
Let me ask, wait a second.
Zip it, you fat jerk. Zip it. All right? Let's get into your heads for just a minute.
Pirates.
Have any of you thought of doing anything for the homeless, for instance?
We have a song on our album State of Euphoria called Who Cares Wins, and all the lyrics are about the homeless problem in New York City.
Are you donating any of that money to the homeless?
We have no idea how to
they
work
have to make
this.
More. You don't have to give your money to the homeless. If you're going to write about it, then stand behind it.
Shut up!
Just tell him. Ace, zip it.
Ace, shut up.
If someone would come to us, we've said numerous times we'd be involved. We did stuff for the American Indians. The homeless problem in New York, we're right behind it. Someone come to us.
Your publisher donating some of his bottom line profit?
Some I write for many publications. Some do.
Which
ones? Name the ones that do.
Name one.
He says some do, but he has to ask.
I want to know what magazines you've written for.
The issue is not who I've written for.
How are you?
Wait, I'm the IRS. What's that matter?
What publication? Name one.
That I write for?
Yeah. Who are you?
I've written for Billboard. I've written for the New York Post.
When?
Recently. That's not the issue here. You guys can't answer the question, so you're throwing it back in my face. The bottom line is, do you donate any of your profits to the homeless? The issue is the homeless. You say you write about it. You're so committed. I'm not finished yet. You say that you write about it. You say that you're committed to the cause. Committing is putting your pocketbook to your big mouth.
Now
wait. Tell me how to answer. I haven't heard an answer yet. I'm
shut
not going
to. Up!
I'm talking to him. Whoa! I'm talking to him.
What is that?
You can't give me an answer.
Shut up and let me talk.
He's talking. Let him talk,
Johnny's A now.
On August 5th, we did a benefit show at the Ritz for the Megaforce 5th anniversary party. It wasn't donated to the homeless, but all the money was donated to the Cancer Foundation, Diabetes Foundation.
What is that gonna do? Hey, man, I've written a about things. I've written for the Musicians Assistance Program, which helps the musicians. Our very own,
baby. In this audience, I see people from Circus Magazine, people from Kerrang, all national publications. How come nobody knows who you are?
Hey, you know something? You just haven't been reading the right publications, my friend.
Let me be right back in just a second with the audience. Come on. We're going to get the audience down. Anytime you guys want to start coming down the loudmouth, you go ahead and do it. But I want to tell you, regardless of the fact that we got a lot of guys here now who will tell you that, yeah, in the old days they experimented with drugs, hey, used drugs and everything else. Now they claim they don't, that they're fighting to keep people from using drugs. That's good. But, Mr. Goldman, give me a little incantation of some of the people
here's
who died.
Here's a litany of the lifestyle of these guys are so proud of. Andy Gibb died of cocaine use. Jimi Hendrix suffocated on his own vomit. Janis Joplin, heroin overdose. Frankie Lyman, heroin overdose. Richard Manuel hung himself. Robbie McIntosh, heroin overdose. Pigpen, cirrhosis of the liver, excessive drinking. Gene Vincent, bleeding ulcer from alcohol. I could go on and on. This is the lifestyle that these guys are proud of.
You just covered 22 years of rock and roll, right, and you only named me about eight people. No, that sounds like a cross-section of America.
No. There are people from every single kind of career you can think
there's
of.
There's 85 people on the list.
And I'm not saying you don't have some snowheads and everything else, all right, in rock and roll. I bet you got some working at Chrysler Corporation, too.
No doubt.
You know. So what do we do? Do we condemn the whole business?
No, we don't.
It's a business else's business in America.
Come on up here, Ben.
I think it's a business.
He's a musician.
I think it's a business just like any other business in America, and I think it's corrupt. And I think that people play dirty pool, and I think people do what they have to do.
When you say corrupt,
I'm a musician from New York. I'm in the middle of the city.
All right, when you say corrupt, when you talk about, let's say, a major American corporation being corrupt, you're usually talking about the management. You're not talking about the guy on the auto workers line.
Right.
All right? So who are we talking about here? It's a corrupt business. Are we talking about the musician? Or are we talking about the guy who runs the business who makes it possible for you to make a buck?
Well, what's music about? I mean, what's it about? Is it about selling style or fashion?
Don't become esoteric for me. Tell me.
I'm not getting esoteric. I mean, that's a real point of view. Music has become a zoo of style and fashion.
It always was. It was, man.
See, now the corporations are behind it.
I remember when Old Gold Cigarettes came out in dancing packs, you know. Look, I mean, that's 30 years ago. It was no different than
there is today. You didn't have every bozo on the street running around with some stupid haircut. I mean,
everybody crawled out from under the rug and got into the music business.
I gotta tell you.
Music should be about making music.
What is the point you're trying to make?
The point is I'm trying to make is that everybody crawled out from under the rug and got into the music business. Now it's like a zoo. It's not like it was in the '60s or the early '70s.
You keep ragging about everyone who has long hair. All right.
No.
If I had Jesus Christ here now, you'd want to crucify him again.
You're absolutely right. I'm just saying, people are getting signed on how long their hair is. What's that all about?
What group has been signed on how long their hair is?
There are advertisements in Musicians Magazine that says, hey, I'm in a band, man, I have long hair. And those are the guys that get the calls. You know,
grow your hair, man!
He's not a musician, pal. He's not a musician like you are, buddy. You're a real musician.
I used to have stupid hair.
I think so. I'll put myself up against anybody.
I think you're a guitar player.
Who's talking to you, man?
I think, you know, you're a human being before you're a musician, and there are things that the music that you're playing is about. It's about your life experience. It's about what you're about as a human being. And that's the most important thing. That's the most important thing in music.
I'm an entertainer.
Isn't it?
I'm an entertainer, I'm a musician.
So what's more important, money or music?
To me?
What's more important?
I like to pay the rent.
I like to do that too.
Yeah,
I also like to. You're very fortunate. You're very fortunate that you are where you're at. Because there's a lot of people out here. Yeah, you look nice. You look beautiful.
You know the sad part about it?
You're taking
the
sad.
Shut
up, too serious.
You know what happens?
I've been playing
the sad part about it. Wait a second, guys. The sad part about it is the system grinds us down into reality. We start off at 21, 22, 25, playing the music, man, because we dig it, because we love it, because it gives a message. And then all of a sudden, we have to pay the rent, and we have to buy diapers for the kid, and we need a car for the wife to take the kid to school now, and we need one for ourselves. And we get trapped, as every generation has before, into earning a living. What's wrong with earning a living?
There's nothing wrong with earning a living. There's nothing wrong with making money. And I mean, it's very, it's American to make money.
It's human.
It's human. It's human.
Everyone wants to make money, right?
It's just
now,
that
it's nice when you make the money, right. You do what you want to do like
and
he
I'm
does.
Happy doing
and
what
use
I do.
Some of the
happy.
Money to help other people. Yeah. Right? Without the government taking it from you. Don't let the government tell you who to help. You decide who to help yourself, all right? Let me go to the... Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, you're saying also donate money. I think that it might be enough just to, like Scott Ian of Anthrax says, he writes songs to raise people's social consciousness. Yeah. So if you don't donate money, at least that's something. I think that's something to
all right, yeah,
for.
Do anything
right,
with your talent.
Exactly.
Do something with your talent other than pave your own bed.
Exactly, because if you donate your talent, that in turn is donating money. So if you don't donate any money, you donate your talent. That's something, man. So don't diss us. Thank you.
Go ahead, sir. Mort,
only in this country, God bless America, can people dress the way they want, say what they want, speak the way they want. If this was Iran now, with the Ayatollah Khamenei, or if this was the Soviet Union now, 3/4 of the people in here tonight would be in jail. But not in this country. God bless the
United States.
All the way.
All right. Yeah. You say, see, he says, only in this country can you dress as you want, right? Baloney, man. Notice I'm wearing a jacket now. I don't like jackets, but they told me I have to wear them. So don't believe it. You gotta wear them, you know. Hey, Ace, you're the fear. Go ahead. I got that loose. Go, ma'am.
There's been a lot said tonight. I haven't heard one thing about fans. We're the ones who wait online in the pouring rain. We're the ones who buy the records. We're the ones who call the radio stations. We're the ones who write the letters to the fan clubs. Not one of you said anything about us. What about us?
That's because these people are.
What about us?
I just want to say, you know, we have a bunch of critics over here. I work at a local hard rock radio station, and we see what's coming in. We see what's new. These people don't jump on a bandwagon until 2 years after the band's made it big. You have talented bands like Circus of Power, talented bands like the Cycle Sluts from Hell here, bands that you people do not support until they've already proven themselves. Who are you? You sit back in an ivory tower, you write about it. How about a little bit of originality in it? You can sit here and you can criticize them and say they're jumping on a bandwagon. You don't know what you're talking about.
I'm not a writer.
About.
I'm a musician, buddy.
I was talking to him right behind you, okay?
You
got somebody like John Zazula over here who signed King's X.
I wrote about Tracy Chapman before she was anybody. I've written about Matty Axe. Let me tell you something. You're picking the wrong argument here. You're picking the wrong argument here.
All right.
That's right. Jesse, take a walk, pal.
Go ahead. Let me go to this gentleman right here. Go ahead, pal.
A few minutes ago, someone passed the remark about Public Enemy.
Yeah.
Okay, now, how come they can make albums about racial hatred, kill the white people, and in the minute someone like Patti Smith does the Easter album, passes a racial remark?
They never said that. Public
right
Enemy
off.
Never said that.
They
buy the record? Did you listen to it?
I have it right from my brother's tape. I listened to it in his car.
All they talk about is black supremacy like all the rest of these bums. They go around like Sharpton and all the rest of them saying, oh, we are the superior race and everything. I listen to the music.
Yeah, they got
the
middle.
And I know. You gotta shut up, all right? Because they're all prejudiced. They're all bums.
Public Enemy, all they say is that it's time, you know, black people, they get a bum deal in this country, and that black, and they're just saying that black, hey, if a white person, yeah, but why can't, okay, but why is a white person, how come you can come out and say that white people, how come you can say white people?
We're the fans. We're the one that buy the records. We have the ultimate decision. Now, if we want to support rock groups, let us support them. They're the best lyricists that there are today. You should hear some of these lyrics.
Yeah, interracial. You know, no color barrier, whatever.
Oh, whoop-de-doo, I'm black and I love heavy metal. Shut your mouth.
All right, tell you what, we're coming back with some rock and roll. Tell you what, no matter, sir, you were at the loudmouth. You wanted to say something? Nothing? You want to say something? Go ahead.
I just wanted to say that a lot of the writers here tonight sound like they don't like music. If they don't like music, why are they writing about it? I write about all kinds of music, metal, new wave, dance music.
Yeah, but see what they do
and,
is
and
they
I
write
I like them. It. I enjoy it. I mean...
They dig lyrics, these guys.
Yeah.
Their own lyrics.
Yeah.
They don't hear the music that people hum.
I mean, you're in this because you like to do it. I mean, as a writer, you don't make a lot of money. You do
you're
it
a writer?
Because you want to, yeah.
Do you enjoy it?
Yes, I love it.
You like heavy metal?
Yeah, I love heavy metal.
All right, I'll tell you. I'll give you heavy metal. I'll give you my buddy Alex. I'll give you the Circus of Power. Alex, you ready to go, baby? Then let's rock and roll is here to stay. Don't try and shove it away, baby. Go.
This song's for everybody that still believes in freedom of thought.
No.
don't know what to do. I ain't heard from you about 16 days.
Channel 9 is the best late date in town. Coming up next on the Arsenio Hall Show, meet Marla Gibbs from TV's 227, Michael Winslow from Police Academy, and singer Tiffany performing her new pop hit, Radio Romance. Make a date with Arsenio Hall, next, here on Channel 9.
About 4, 1, or 2. The more I drink, the more I think, the more I'm bound to lose. You rattled my snake and you took my hide. Moved my train, moved me all down the line. All down the line. Oh, I sent letters home to mama, but you know.
Because of our decadent lifestyle, supposedly.
What is your decadent lifestyle, Joey?
Coming on the Morton Downey Show.
He's provocative, and so are we.
John Lennon's dead, and Motley Crue's
doesn't
just another
John,
dime a dozen
band. He's a genius. Band. His music still lives with us.
Why is he a genius? Why is he a genius?
What genius?
Why is he a genius? How did he change your life?
I didn't say you have to change my luck to be a genius.
Why is he a genius?
Musical genius, a writer, an incredible musician. You never realized that. Where have you been for the last 30 years?
That's what critics are for. I mean, if they couldn't slam someone, if they had to say they liked everything, it'd be no job for a critic.
Yeah, what are you doing here?
They paid my way.
Go away.
I bet you he goes home and listens to Bon Jovi at night.
I just want to say one thing. If I ever came home looking like you, my mother would throw me the hell out of the house.
I mean, look at the way you dress, man. You think these kids are going to know any better?
Hey, listen, I'd kill myself if I dressed like you.
Some of the meatheads were kind of endearing in their own special way.
Kind of.
I mean, you know, it makes for a good show.
You get angry at that which you do not understand, right? A lot of people don't understand it.
We love Morton.
Yeah, he kept saying me in all the breaks. He would say, that loudmouth says one important thing to you. Go get him, Alex.
You know, Mort used to be a singer, and he's a songwriter, and I think there'll be some type of rapport.
Ain't nothing wrong with that, pal. That's just good music.
Format lets you pretty much say what you want to say. There's no other shows like that.
Did you know of other groups that use drugs, or did you use drugs? Your group.
Did my group use drugs? Not really.
Okay. So,
I don't know what we're going to all be doing 15 years from now. A lot of rock stars are dog groomers and everything else. Where are the cycle sluts from hell going to be 15 years from now? Probably working in my dog grooming place.
I walk along the street of sorrow.
Morton was the best. Morton's the best.
No argument there. Morton Downey has an album of his own coming out soon, by the way, called Morton Downey Jr. Sings. It's due out April 3rd. The second of Downey's rock shows will air next week. Try to catch it. That's the news for now. Stay tuned for more music on MTV.
MTV News.